everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to a brand new video and welcome to MiniCrate video number 2 for January 2018. If you happen to have missed MiniCrate video number 1 for January 2018, where I unboxed this awesome miniature called Ashes to Ashland from Privateer Press, check out the link in the video description. It's a really cool unboxing and it's an amazing figure, as you can see in front of you. The second part of these MiniCrate Challenge videos is where I do sort of a masterpiece gallery style video where I put the miniature on a spinning base and I just kind of let you guys soak it in while I talk about my experiences painting the miniature. And I gotta tell you, I had a ton of fun with this one. This was a real challenge miniature for me, especially in a couple of areas, because it really heavily relied on a lot of wet blending, which is something I'm not really used to implementing a lot in my miniature painting. I'm much more of a layer painter, but utilizing these mini crate challenges as I am to challenge my skills as a painter and to pull out skills and tactics that I don't use very frequently, I came across Ashes to Ashland here as the MiniCrate miniature for the month of January 2018, and I gotta tell you, it was a lot of fun, but it's definitely something I probably would have not picked up on my own, and it's definitely something that challenged my skills as far as pushing me outside of my comfort zone. This miniature was a lot of fun to do. I got to work with a lot of wet blending, like I said, which I don't normally do. And to be perfectly honest with you, after doing this miniature and doing so much wet blending, I might actually implement it in a more frequent basis on some of my other miniatures, because I found that trying to do certain techniques with a layering style technique make things a little bit more difficult in some cases. I actually started off with this whole miniature trying to do layering across the entire model, and in some areas it just did not work. I couldn't make the layering style work. And so transferring over to the wet blend, I was able to achieve the same style results that I would normally get with a layering style of painting, but in a very short amount of time with a lot less headache. A lot of fun to paint. As I said, I got to work with some really cool metallics as well. I don't do a whole lot of metallic painting. Normally, I reserve that for just weaponry and things like that. And I went through a period years and years and years ago when Rackham was popular, wherein I really only worked with non-metallic metals. And so getting back into working in full metallics over almost an entire miniature was definitely a treat for me, and again, a challenge. I utilized some very, very unique techniques in this miniature. I won't talk about them here in this video. I want to save that for my Patreon exclusive stuff, but I got to tell you, it's a there's some pretty cool little hidden gems in this miniature that upon initial viewing, your brain might notice them, but you won't quite know why. So if you're interested in learning very specifically some of the techniques I use to actually paint this miniature, as well as a nice color map of all of the colors utilized over this miniature, at least the major areas, and how I applied them, what I did to make them look the way I did, definitely check out my Patreon page. The link for that's down there in the video description. And along with this video, the description video that will be coming out as a Patreon exclusive video this weekend, there are many other Patreon exclusive videos as well. And there will always be a Patreon exclusive video each time I complete one of these mini crate challenges that I've set forward for myself. Very, very, very cool miniature. Lots of fun to paint, as I said. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. It was just an absolute blast. And I really, as I said, the point of these mini crate challenges is for the most part to force me to paint miniatures that I would not ordinarily pick up off of a shelf. But in some ways it's nice, and I found that out on this particular model, because as I said, I'm forcing myself not just to paint a different type of miniature, but also to paint with different styles that I wouldn't ordinarily use. And it's been just so fun and so rewarding to take on this mini crate challenge as I have, And it's an absolute blast. And I cannot wait to get into the next one. This is such a fun experience for me. And I'm really, really looking forward to showing you guys what's up for next month and exactly how I'm going to get that miniature done. And then every month following that, it's just going to be a treat. And I hope you guys will stick around with me. Again, if you want more in-depth coverage as to what specifically I did to paint this particular miniature, check out my Patreon page. You can subscribe for as little as a dollar, but there are reward levels up a little bit higher value that where you can get your own kind of mini crate each month if you want, or you can get some of my how to paint DVDs. I have a huge line of how to paint DVDs, and they can teach you how to do stuff just like this. But again, check out the Patreon page. A lot of cool stuff over there. And this weekend, I'll be posting up a video detailing exactly how I painted MiniCrate miniature number 4 from Privateer Press called Ashes to Ashlyn. Very, very cool model. Very fun to paint, as I said. And I hope that you guys have enjoyed looking at the box opening, if you saw that, and looking at the finished product here. It's a lot of fun to paint. A lot of fun to experiment around with some new techniques and things. And it's just been a blast. I can't say enough good things about this miniature. I really, really thoroughly enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun. Hope that you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions so you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. And again, please feel free to check out my Patreon page. Every bit of contribution that comes in really helps to improve the quantity and the quality of the videos on this channel, and I do appreciate everyone's financial support. Thank you once again for watching. It really means the world to me. God bless you all. Have a phenomenal rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.